Chris, I want to ask you about your new shoes that you're debuting tonight. What a big deal that is. How excited are you for that?
What happened now?
Your new shoes that you're wearing tonight.
What new shoes you talking about, Liz?
What? You can't talk about your new shoes?
What you talking about?
You're on court shoes. Come on, Russ. That's a big deal.
No, I don't know what you're talking about.
Russ. Okay, you start the new year off. It would be a big deal to get some momentum here on this road trip. What are y'all looking forward to?
Looking forward to getting a win. You know, we lost the last two, going out and making sure we take care of business.
Do you feel like in the last couple of games, the offense has kept moving, but maybe the defense has slipped a little? How do you get those on the same level you want them on?
We're okay. We know we need to defend, and it's easy to get back to where we need to.
Russell, what kind of memories come back being in this building again?
We never played in here. Played in Pauley. Well,
practice here playing like we can here right now?
No, we practice in Pauley.
What's your thoughts on, as a unit, defensively, what you all can do to make up for the loss of Andre in the next few days?
I mean, he's hard to make up for the things he does because they don't show up in the stat sheet. But we just, as collectively, as a unit, we got to make sure we go out and compete defensively.
Have you ever had a team defensively that's as good with you and Andre and Paul and
I don't know, not sure. We've been pretty good defensively, historically, too. But definitely a good group of guys defensively that are locking down every night.
Do Andre and Paul like kind of fight over who gets to guard the best player?
Well, we all want to guard the best other team best player, but we all know we can switch and guard every position. That's the benefit of having size and length.
How would you describe the feeling of the offense right now compared, obviously, to the beginning of the season?
It's good. I mean, we know it's going to be a process every single night, and we're steady learning each other and learning each other's games and figuring out.
And what is it about this group specifically that makes that defensive cohesion so intact?
Just everybody has each other back. It's important. Defense is a five-man defense, not one man, it's not two men. You got to have your teammates back when they get beat and make sure you cover for the teammates.
From the beginning, Billy's always talked about T. Ferg's defense. What have you noticed from him on that side of the floor?
Just his aggressiveness.
Is extended time on the road, Russ, beneficial this time of the year to continue the bonding chemistry process for you guys?
It's good, both home and a road, in my opinion.
Have you seen much Alonzo this
year? Not much, no.
What have you seen of him?
Say it again?
What have you seen of him?
Not much, just when he was here at UCLA, a little bit. Some clips just now just seen from this morning.
What did you take away from the clips he saw this morning?
Nothing. He can play. You know, I treat every opponent the same.
Do you, you came out of UCLA also. Do you think that being at UCLA could have prepared him for the attention that he got in the NBA, or is it totally different?
I'm not sure.
Hey, Rosa, you know, obviously Paul's coming to LA here, and the first time he's playing the Lakers. The obvious questions about his free agency and all that. How do you guys approach this scene, this environment?
Good point.
Did you talk to him about it, or did you ever think about the future?
Paul's all home to see his Thunder, that's all I know.
Do you feel like you're making a sales pitch to him this season?
A who?
A sales pitch to him this season?
No. Sales pitch is going when we win a championship. Beat that pitch.
You personally, how do you feel like your progression through this year with your new teammates is going at this point in time?
Going better, better and better.
Anyone else? Thanks, Russ.
Thanks, Russell.